The National Map is a collection of mapping products and services produced by the USGS National Geospatial Program. The products and services are accessed via the Internet through service calls and graphical user interfaces. The National Geospatial Program has released a series of how-to videos for people who are working with the National Map data and services. The videos show how to use the services and interfaces to access data and tools for viewing, analyzing, and printing geospatial data. The training materials are a mixture of video and PowerPoint-based lessons. Lessons 1 and 2 serve as an introduction to the training materials. The remaining lessons are designed as quick how-tos and may be viewed as needed in any order depending on the user. Any use of trade, product, or firm names is for descriptive purposes only and does not imply endorsement by the U.S. government. Lesson 10D1, Importing Data into LP360. LP360 is a family of tools for visualizing, manipulating, and editing point cloud data, and are offered both as an extension for ArcGIS and as a standalone desktop platform for Windows. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to open Lidar point cloud last data files in the LP360 viewer, visualize the data in 2D and 3D, change the visualization using toolbar functions, and turn on all or specific Lidar point classes. Before we begin, you will want to download some Lidar data to use during our exercise. For this lesson, we've conveniently packaged 6 tiles of last data into a zip file called USGS, LPC, CO, Soplat River, Data, 4 Lessons.zip, and loaded it to our FTP website. Please navigate to this location and download the zip package. Note that this package file is over 700 megabytes and may take 10 to 15 minutes to download. After you've downloaded the LiDAR data, extract the zip file into a folder on your local computer to use during this lesson. The National Map has a download client where you can find USGS products to include elevation data such as LiDAR point clouds. If you are interested in learning more about downloading products on the National Map, be sure to check out our training videos. LP360 is available in 6 licensing levels, with capabilities ranging from simple point cloud visualization to more advanced QA/QC classification and analysis functions. We are using the standalone LP360 viewer license, version 2018.1.57.7, for this tutorial. The standalone LP360 viewer license is freely available through the manufacturer. If you do not already have the LP360 viewer on your computer, please visit this support site and click on the Get Support button below the LP360 logo. Type LP360 in the subject line of the email and type, "I am writing to request a license for the LP360 viewer," in the body of the email. You will receive a license manager and instructions for setting up LP360. Your systems administrator may need to assist you. Additionally, for supplementary information about LP360 viewer tools, please reference the tool guide. Launch the LP360 viewer. When LP360 loads, you will see the View pane, the Table of Contents pane, the LP360 toolbar, and the Display and Navigation toolbar. Toolbars can be toggled on and off through the View menu. If you click on the View menu, you should see checkmarks next to the LP360 toolbar, Display and Navigation toolbar, and the Table of Contents. If not, toggle them on now. LP360 is a point cloud tool, however, in addition to opening last files, it can also load vector and raster data with ease. To load last files, you can either click File, Open, Last Files, or click the Add Last/Raster Layer button. In the Add Files window, click on the green Add button and browse to the location of the LiDAR point cloud last files that were downloaded from the FTP site. Click on the file name, USGS, LPC, CO, Soplat River, Lot 5, 2013, 13SDD480395, LAS 2015, and click Open. In the Open Settings Preferences, click the radio button to select Open Read Only. Under the Load Settings, select Load Files, and under Options, toggle the Pyramid option and accept the default thinning value of 16, then click OK. This LiDAR tile is in Apex Open Space Park just west of Golden, Colorado. After a few seconds, you should see the one tile of LiDAR data displayed in the view pane, and a LAS Layer 1 added to the TOC tab of the Table of Contents. The LAS Files tab shows additional information about this layer. Under the LAS Layer 1, we can see that this layer contains one file and the name of the LiDAR tile that we loaded in the previous step. The load icon next to the LiDAR tile name tells us the LiDAR points are currently loaded. Double-clicking on this icon will unload the data and cause it to disappear from the view pane. This is especially helpful when you have multiple tiles loaded. Double-clicking the load icon again will reload the data. The view pane defaults to display the full extent of the data. You can use the display and navigation toolbar to explore the data further. This tutorial will cover the most relevant buttons, however you may refer to the LP360 tool guide for a more comprehensive reference. This toolbar provides multiple options for zooming in and out and panning through the data layer. The zoom in and zoom out buttons enable you to zoom in or out of a spot of the map by left-clicking in the view pane or by left-clicking and dragging a rectangle in the view pane. Additionally, if you want to move around the view pane without changing your zoom, you can use the pan button to maneuver around to a new area. The zoom previous button returns to the previous zoom level. And finally, the full extent button returns to the default map view. The LP360 toolbar enables us to easily change visualizations using the legend types and draw types drop-down menu. Legend types displays points based on attribute values such as elevation, classification, intensity, and point source ID. The availability of various legend types is dependent upon the attributes present in the loaded LiDAR tile. By default, LP360 visualizes the last point values using a display by elevation rainbow color palette, where blue corresponds to the lowest elevation and red corresponds to the highest elevation values. Notice that the TOC tab in the table of contents also displays elevation as the current legend type. Click on the legend types drop-down menu and select display by classification. The legend on the TOC tab now displays all possible point classifications. Note that not all of these point classifications will be represented in our LAS tile. In fact, from the view pane, we can see that in our LAS file, most of the points are classified as ground, colored in orange, unclassified, colored in gray, and high noise colored in pink. Now click on the legend types drop-down menu and select display by intensity. This is displaying LiDAR points as a gradient from black to white based on the intensity of the return pulse. Intensity is a measure of the surface reflectance and will be higher, lighter colors, for surfaces with stronger reflectance back to the LiDAR sensor, and lower, darker, for surfaces with less reflectance. Up until this point, we have only been visualizing the LAS file based on point classifications. However, the Draw Types drop-down menu provides additional options for viewing data as different surface types. Click the Draw Types drop-down menu and select Display the Triangulated Irregular Network, or TIN surface. This draw type draws a TIN surface on the fly based on the attributes of the input LiDAR points. The view pane is now displaying a continuous surface derived from LiDAR point intensity values. We can now see a lot more detail of the landscape, including trees, a rock quarry, and a road. Now use the Legend Types drop-down menu to view the original display by elevation legend as a TIN surface. Displaying the elevation values as a TIN surface gives us an excellent view of the topography of the area. However, notice how some of the finer features, such as roads, are harder to identify with this legend as compared to the previous display by intensity legend. LP360 provides the ability to apply intensity shading on top of the current display surface. Similar to the Legend Types tool, the ability to use the Apply Intensity Shading tool is dependent upon the existence of intensity values within your last dataset. Now click the Apply Intensity Shading button to the right of the Draw Type button. You should now see an intensity shading applied to the elevation surface. The addition of the intensity shading accentuates many of the finer features on the surface, such as roads and striations in the rock quarry. Though the view pane is displaying a lot of detail in the surface, we can see on the LP360 toolbar that our view is currently only displaying 1.56% of the data. At this scale, it is not necessary to use 100% of the points to observe characteristics of the land surface. Additionally, thinning the data allows for greater performance while exploring the dataset. However, LP360 does provide a Force 100% resolution tool, which will force all points to be drawn on the screen. Click the Force 100% resolution button. Because this is the first time using the Force 100% resolution tool, you should see the full resolution help tip pop up. The tool tip warns that since rendering 100% of the LiDAR points is very memory intensive, the number of points drawn may exceed the maximum cache size allowed by this tool, resulting in only a subset of the surface being generated. Since the view pane is currently displaying the entire extent of the last data, this tool will fail to force the 100% resolution on the entire tile. Note, this tool tip will only pop up if this is the first time using the Force 100% resolution button during this session. Click No to exit the tool tip. Using the Zoom In tool on the Display and Navigation toolbar, zoom in on the building in the lower left corner. This is the Mother Cabrini Shrine in Golden, Colorado. The drop-down menu below the view pane shows the current scale of the display. This will be grayed out in the LP360 Viewer License software version. Using the Zoom In tool, zoom in until the scale display reads just under 1 to 1000. Now that we are zoomed into a smaller region, click the Force 100% resolution button again. On the LP360 toolbar, you should now see that the view pane is displaying 100% of the data. Displaying 100% of the data on the subset of our last tile significantly increases the details we can observe in the view pane. The outlines of the buildings and hedges are now sharply defined, and we can even make out lines in the parking lot. Now deselect the Force 100% resolution button and use the Full Extent button on the Display Navigation toolbar to return to the full extent of the last tile. LP360 also makes it very simple to view the data in 3D. Start by activating the Viewer Integration toolbar. This is accomplished by clicking on the drop-down view menu and clicking the Viewer Integration toolbar. The Viewer Integration toolbar will now appear in the LP360 window. To use the 3D window, click the Toggle 3D Display button. By default, the 3D window opens up without any data in it. You can also open the 3D window through the View drop-down menu. However, since your 3D window is already open, you should see a checkmark next to the 3D window option showing that it is active. Now toggle the table of contents to hide it from view. We will now select the data to display in the 3D window. Click the 3D Draw Viewer Extent button. This will activate a selector cursor in the 2D view pane that can be used to choose data to display in the 3D window. We will look at the rock quarry in the lower right-hand corner of the last tile. Draw an extent box over the quarry by left-clicking the cursor and dragging a box over the area of interest. When you let go of the cursor, you will see a new white-bounded box drawn in the 2D window. The 3D window is now displaying a 3D rendering of the point cloud data contained within the bounding box. We can explore the data in the 3D view using the mouse buttons. To zoom, click and hold the left mouse button while moving your mouse forward and backwards. To rotate the 3D view, click and hold the right mouse button and drag the tile around to a new angle. Similar to the 2D view pane, the 3D window also enables us to visualize data by changing draw types and legend types. On the 3D window toolbar, use the Draw Types drop-down menu to select Display Tin Surface. Also on the 3D window toolbar, ensure that the button that toggles hill shading of the tin surface is turned on. Now as you zoom and pan around the 3D window, you will notice large spikes protruding from the surface. Since we are displaying all the data point classifications, these spikes show the high noise point classifications present in our data. LP360 provides several methods to filter data in order to only display the data that are of interest to us. Additionally, 2D and 3D filters are separate, so you can change filter parameters in one window independently of the other. First, in both the 2D and 3D view windows, you will see a drop-down menu with the filter currently set to all points. The filter drop-down option provides several preset options, such as ground and canopy. Keep in mind that the availability of these filters will depend on the classifications within your last tile. Using the filter drop-down in the 3D view, select ground. The 3D window now only displays points that have been classified as ground. Next, we can also select points of interest by changing the display properties for our last tile. Click on the display properties icon in the 3D window. This will open the viewer properties window for the last tile. The viewer properties window provides a lot of options to customize point symbology and point filters, which are beyond the scope of this tutorial. In the viewer properties window, click on the display tab. This will open the points filter tab, showing the classifications tab. Be sure that the use points filter for the tin option is toggled on. If not, toggle it on now. This classifications tab displays the ASPRS class values and names that may be present within our last data set. Notice that since we selected the predefined ground filter in the previous step, currently only class 2 ground and class 8 reserved are toggled on. In the classifications tab, toggle on class 1 unclassified and then click apply. In the 3D window, you should now see sparse vegetation appear on the ground surface. The classifications tab provides complete control over which point classifications to view or exclude from the view. Click cancel to exit the viewer properties window. Now click apply intensity shading on the 3D window toolbar. As we saw in the 2D view, applying intensity shading sharpens fine surface details such as the quarry striations and the vegetation. In addition to the 2D and 3D views, LP360 Viewer provides profile view options, which can be useful for further data exploration. To simplify the view interface, close the 3D view window by deselecting the Toggles the 3D Window button. Now on the Viewer Integration toolbar, click the Toggle Profile Window button to activate the profile view. The profile view window will appear in the bottom of the LP360 Viewer window. Select the Draw the Profile Box in 2D View and Draw the Profile Centerline in 2D View buttons. Now click the Draw a Profile Line button. To create a profile in the 2D view pane, first click on a hill on one side of the valley, then move your cursor to the hill across the valley and click again, thereby creating the center line for the profile view. To adjust the width, move your cursor perpendicular to the center line. When you are satisfied with the width, click a third time to make your selection. The points contained within your profile box are now displayed in the profile view. Now enlarge the profile view by hovering your cursor at the top of the pane until a resize icon appears. Then click and drag the bar up to resize the window until you can view the extent of the profile. As with the 2D and 3D view windows, the profile view also contains the legend types menu and the display properties menu. The profile view is another convenient method to explore point classifications and attributes contained while simultaneously viewing the underlying topography of the surface. You've finished lesson 10D1, Importing Data into LP360. In this lesson, we discussed how to load a single last file into LP360, explore the data in 2D, 3D, and profile views, and use the LP360 display and navigation and viewer integration toolbars. We also learned how to filter LiDAR data by classification and apply symbology based on LiDAR point attributes.